Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad.
Chapter 16, Breaking Up. When you finally took the courage, you went to your room and saw Flowey crying on your bed. You sat next to him. As you did, he said, "You want me to leave, don't you? I understand." And then he started to jump on the way out of your house. But before he could reach your bedroom's door, you said, "Flowey." And then he turned around. "You can stay because I like you too." And after that, Flowey became red like a tomato. He ran to you and jumped over you, making you throw back. Then he started to hit your chest while screaming, "You idiot. You idiot. I love you." You picked him up and then gave him a kiss. His blush became even more darker, so he kissed you back. After you two finished the kiss, Flowey said, "This is the very best day of my life." While leaning his head on your chest, you hugged him. You stood like that for 2 hours, until your mother called both of you for dinner. You went, you had dinner, then had a shower and finally went to bed. At 9:22 a.m., you both got up. After having breakfast, you two decided to take a walk. As you walked, Flowey said, "Y/N. I don't want to ruin the moment, but and you asked, "But," and Flowey continued, "When are you going to tell Papyrus that you know and you reacted, "Yeah, I kinda forgot about that." And Flowey added, "It's okay if you don't want to tell him." After all, you are still in love with Hai, and you interrupted, "You know what? I'm telling him today that everything is over." I don't want to live in a lie anymore. And then, you and Flowey kissed. After you and Flowey finished kissing each other, you both went to your house, and as soon as you arrived, you grabbed your phone and texted Papyrus, "Hey Papyrus. Are you free today? Because I wanted you to come to my home. I got to tell you something." And he immediately responded, "Wowie. Okay. I'll be there at 5 p.m. See ya, sweetie." It was 12:33 p.m. and you had 4 hours with 27 minutes to prepare to tell Papyrus the truth. You and Flowey went to your room. Flowey offered to practice the conversation you were going to have with Papyrus, but before you two could start practicing, your mother called you for lunch. It was 2:06 p.m. when you and Flowey finished having lunch, then Flowey and you rushed to your room. Once you were there, you started to practice. "Wow, human. You look so cute." Dot, Flowey said, trying to imitate Papyrus. "Hello, Papyrus. I wanted to tell you something." You responded, "Oh, what is it, sweetie?" Flowey kept imitating Papyrus. "I wanted to tell you that and then you refused. I can't do this." And Flowey added, "Yes, you can. At the moment that you are going to tell Papyrus the truth. I'll be there to support you." And then you said, "Thanks." And after that, Flowey blushed and exclaimed, "Don't make me blush, you idiot." And afterwards that you started to laugh while blushing. After a few hours of practicing the conversation that you were going to have with Papyrus, the clock struck 4:45 p.m., so there were only 15 minutes left until the moment of the truth. You were so nervous and anxious that you threw up lunch. When you finished throwing up, the doorbell rang. At that moment you were paralyzed. You thought, "I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't." And suddenly Flowey hit your leg and said, "Come on, Yen. We can do it." And then you both went to open the door. As you opened the door, Papyrus came in and hugged you. He said, "Hi, Y/N. I'm glad you invited me to come here." And you added, "Yeah." And suddenly you felt like going to throw up again. You ran to the bathroom and started to throw up again. Papyrus, worried, asked what happened, and Flowey answered, "Nothing. Could you stay here for 5 minutes?" And Papyrus responded, "Fine." And then Flowey rushed to the bathroom. Obviously, Papyrus wasn't going to stay there. Instead of that, he went to your room and started to peek in your drawers and took the photo of you and Flowey. Then he took another photo out of his pocket. It was the photo that he took in the amusement park with you. He started to compare both of the photos and soon noticed that in the photo you were with Flowey you were smiling and blushing, but in the photo you were with Papyrus you weren't. As Papyrus noticed it, he started to cry. He said, "Y/N," while sobbing, but suddenly he stopped crying because he heard you and Flowey coming out of your bathroom. He left the photo of you and Flowey on your desk and then rushed to your living room. You came back with Flowey. This time you were going to say it. You were going to ditch Papyrus. "Are you all right, sweetie?" Papyrus asked. You responded, "I'm fine." You kept talking, "Papyrus. I got to tell you something very important." While you approached to him, Papyrus grabbed you by your shoulders and said, "I'm listening." And you stood in silence for a while. Papyrus. "We should." And Papyrus asked, "We should," while starting to grab you tighter. Papyrus. "We should break up." And as Papyrus heard that, he started to laugh like a psychopath.
I'm glad you enjoyed the video. Before we close the video, I noticed 53% of you guys are not subscribed to the channel. If you can, please subscribe to the channel. Hit that like button, hit that notification bell, and leave a comment down below. Until next time, goodbye!